So he took that cannon blast, and it only cost him a leg. Got to say, I'm impressed. What is he doing now?
We supplied him with tools and materials. He has been working in his chamber ever since.
He seemed willing to enter the Shogun's services. How does he plan to compensate for his disability?
We will know soon enough. How was your scouting mission, Hayato-san?
We had a look at Lord Yabu's mansion. Big place, heavily guarded. It's closed off by a wall, but Yuki found a way inside.
That sounds promising. Speaking of whom, where is Yuki-chan?
Here, Master Samurai.
I must say, Mugen, your young companion is full of curiosity.
Good to see you, old man.
Ah, the young shinobi. Hayato, is it? Good to see you, too.
Takuma-san, are you ready for the field?
A bit rusty, maybe. Oh, everything weighs less in my memory.
Then, let us discuss strategy. Lord Yabu's guilt is proven. He might only be allied with Kage-sama, but I believe he is the man himself.
Only one way to find out. If we want to get him, we better move now.
No doubt he will see us coming. It will be the most dangerous mission yet.
Then we must be prepared. Here. I made one for each of you.
Matchlock pistols? Never seen one so small. Not too shabby, old man.
A last resort for desperate times. My first contribution. May Yabu's downfall be the next.
Guess I'll come with you then. You'll need all the help you can get.
Oh, I want to come too.
I appreciate your support.
Very well. You have my blessings to do whatever is necessary. I shall travel to Edo. The Shogun will want to know of our plan.
Then I will accompany you. It has been a long time since we enjoyed a peaceful moment together.
I would be honored, Aiko-san. Let us prepare for the journey.
So, the three of us against a powerful daimyo in his heavily guarded mansion. I've had worse odds.
Some things there want to be taken. But we won't come for things. We'll come for Lord Yabu.
A mercenary, a cripple, and a child. They will tell stories about this one.
So, this should be time for the game to hit its stride. We now have access to every single character on the list. And I think we're doing our first mission, aside from the very brief part of the actual first mission, where we're going to have three proper characters for a mission in the same time. I assume that the game, by the end, will have five player missions, and that'll be possibly terrifyingly complex.
More guards than last time. I guess Lord Yabu wants to make this challenging.
He knows I have been freed. His fears are well justified.
Three bodyguards, armored clothing, never leaves the courtyard. Don't think we should attack head on.
He drinks tea, right?
What?
Such a fine.
He always drinks tea on that little island.
Hey, not a bad idea. Take this flask, child. You can add a little death to his drink.
What about that tower? Think you can take the shot from there?
Not impossible, if we manage to coax him out of cover first.
His bodyguards. They'll see him die, yes? Then everyone will search for us.
Sounds like the perfect moment to use those matchlock pistols you gave us.
We should save them until that point. I also bought a couple of bombs in case things get dire.
Good to know. All right, let's get going.
Interesting. Yep, the pistols went and found their way into our last slot now. That explains the blank that we've had. I wonder if that'll be a cycling item that comes and goes over time. Let's find out what our new character does. He can climb ladders, which is rather impressive. Maybe a little difficult. He cannot carry bodies and cannot enter water. Important detail there. So if he kills anyone, he can't carry them around. Although, if he's in sniper mode, he's unlikely to be killing anybody. He's unlikely to be killing anybody from a distance where he can actually take their body anyway. Let's see. Use your rifle for a long-range attack. Keep track of your ammunition. So we only have 5 shots. So we can take 5 snipe shots and that's it. So we have to be careful about which ones we use. Throw a grenade for a very loud, long-range area attack. That's nice.
Fireworks are ready.
So not that long-range, though. It is long-range, but not about as far as you'd expect him to be able to throw it, basically. So that would kill everyone within the circle, I assume, but then everyone within the blue circle gets notified. I assume it'll kill samurai too? Maybe not? I don't know what to expect of an explosion. I don't know how invincible we're supposed to think samurai are. In this mission's case, if a samurai shows up, I have to assume that would kill him, because there's nobody here to kill a samurai. Maybe bullets kill samurai too? Let's see, a matchlock pistol has a strong ranged attack.
Medium range will do.
So it goes that far. Oh! Interesting element here. The matchlock pistol has a big sound radius, but the bullet can actually travel further than the sound radius, so you can shoot it twice as far as the noise radius, meaning that you could potentially be shooting people from a spot where no one would spot you. Or hear you, at least. You might have to stand up in order to shoot a pistol. Let's see, place the Tanuki. It can howl to lure enemies towards it.
Ready?
So I can just put a Tanuki wherever and it'll help, and then what? Did they ever hurt a Tanuki? Did they ever hurt the Tanuki? Or are they just like, hey look, a Tanuki! It's over here, existing! That'd be interesting. Let's see. Let's place it away from anyone, just so I can play with it a little bit. What happens when I put the Tanuki down?
He's cute. Is he your friend?
You could say that. Kuma, listen. Your turn.
When does it howl? Oh, there's a new letter over here.
Kuma, distract them. Distract them.
Oh, he's clever.
That he certainly is.
What do people do if they find a Tanuki, though? I think... Is the idea that he's just adorable? Because I'll accept that. He did, like, do a little roll and stuff. Okay. So, he can just walk around and distract people. Sure. Alright, with that taken care of. Call Tanuki back. There we go. So holding...
Never seen a tame Tanuki. How did you train it?
What makes you think I trained him? Maybe it's the other way around.
Uh-huh.
Okay, so holding D brings him back.
You did well.
But tapping D just gives him assigns him a new location to go to. This whole area looks surprisingly open and lacking in coverage. I see 3 guards. 1, 2, 3. Guy on the right, guy in the middle, guy on the left. This guy's up here. I don't think I've seen him move yet, though. I think he's just been hanging out, so I think he stays in that position. Oh, a scroll. Okay, so this beginning part seems kind of linear. Oh, you can kind of go out in the field? Nah, that doesn't go anywhere, though. I don't see a reason to go out in the field over here. So my goal is to get through this door. Seems like there might be a lot of guards behind the door for me to worry about. And this is where he gets his good... He can get up there, they said, and take a sniper shot. Who's he going to take the shot at, though? The Yabu? Because I thought the Yabu was supposed to be poisoned. Kill Yabu. So put a poison in his tea. Yuki has the flask. Or lure him into sight and shoot him from the tower. Okay, so there's 2 different options. There's 2 different routes to the mission. And then just escape via the South Road, which I believe is where we're starting. Okay. This almost seems like it'd be a short mission. If I just have to clear my way to the sniper spot and then shoot him? That doesn't seem too bad. Okay, there is a decent density of guards to deal with around here. Look at these three guys, for example. And I don't see a lot of hiding spots. Just a lot of the bushes are relatively sparsely located. So how about that poison opportunity? I'd have to go all the way down here. The character with the poison flask can swim. Do I have to reach the civilian that has the tea? So he comes down here and has tea.
The tea was almost cold.
Ah, so he's just a dick, huh? Alright, so he's going over. She's gonna what? Just pour more tea? Okay. So how do I poison the flask? She's going over here. I don't want to be on this island. It's completely drowning in guards. There's way too many of them. So there must be somewhere the civilian goes where I can try to catch them, right? If I just take out a few guards, for example. Are you going upstairs? Oh, she goes inside and stops there. Okay, then she presumably comes back out. How do I poison his tea? Does she come down here and pour him tea before she's here? And then can I poison the tea? What's the gong do? Does that alert everyone to this location? Is it that's gongs are alarms, right? That's usually what they do in a stealth game. Okay, waiting for her is getting annoying. Let's try loading. Oh, that started the whole mission over. I haven't done anything yet, so that's fine. There we go. We'll just skip this dialogue. I just want to catch her doing what she does. And now I don't see her doing anything. This whole place looks like a nightmare to sneak through. I probably just want to stay. I think I like the sniper idea better. Trying to go through the middle of this place could be a nightmare. But one sneaky ninja coming in and creating a noise distraction. Okay, yeah, I don't see her. Huh. One appeal of doing the sniper tactic that I'm thinking of right now is that I feel like I'm going to misinterpret how to do the tea method. I'm not really sure how to poison it. Like, what, do I put the poison in the well? I don't think so. Do I wait for it to set the table, then poison it? In which case, I have a whole island of guards to deal with, which isn't not an amazing amount, but still a problem. What's the deal with this guy? There's like a dog here? That's a big dog. So how do I just, and is that how I distract for the sniper shot? I probably have to bring him over here to get line of sight. Let's see here.
Such a fine view.
So it seems like he can just shoot wherever. Range 55. So he can shoot all the way this far away. You just need a clear line of sight within the 3D world. That's why he needs to get up on that spot. Okay. So I don't think that's even mandatory to go up here specifically, but it seems like it might just be the ideal location to try to kill him. Let's leave that for now. Okay, let's start working on how to just actually get to the front gate. That's obviously the first thing to deal with. Let's see.
Kuma, listen.
First guy could just be distracted. That shouldn't be too hard. Everyone should crouch before I forget. I don't know why I just quick saved as if anything happened.
Solution.
Let's test how this distraction Kuma. Works.
Go, Kuma.
He's cute. Is he your friend?
You could say that, creature. Distract them.
Oh, he's clever.
And he certainly is.
So it seems that he'll just be like, aw, adorable. Oh, look, he's doing a handstand. Okay, so I think that might be an infinite distraction. Cool. this guy's the next issue, and he's presumably distraction immune. This guy kind of goes out of range, though.
No noise. I'll go up.
So much youthful energy.
I'm going in.
So I should be able to sneak up here. Maybe I'll bring you up too.
Jump, climb. Now that's easy.
So I think we can just shuriken this guy.
Shuriken. I never miss.
Okay, that's. No, that's not ideal. So the random civilian gets in the way there. But
a wise choice. No one will notice.
There may be another trick to do here.
Let's see what's up there.
So let's try this again.
So much youthful energy.
What if I lure him closer with the flute play?
Kuma.
What?
He's cute.
Oh, I double clicked for a second there.
You could say that.
Come on over here.
The path is blocked.
5T.
Charms, Kuma.
Anyone here?
Distract them.
Oh, he's clever.
He certainly is.
Move like water.
There we go. Got him. There we go. And no one suspected a thing. And this is how you use all three characters in concert with each other. The first thing I... Oh, it's not an infinite distraction. He gives up. Okay. Well, if that's the case, now we know at least.
Kuma, come back.
Should be pretty easy just to kill this guy right now, though.
How did you train it?
What makes you think I trained him? Maybe it's the other way around.
What makes you think I trained him? Maybe it's the other way around. That's the same way people talk about their cats. It's like, this cat actually owns this house. So there's two civilians out here I don't want to get spotted by. That's a slight problem. Other than that, it's just the one dude, right? There's a door on this side. Is there one on... Nope. We could use hooks. Probably. To jump from ceiling to roof to roof. Let's maybe see what I can do with one of these guys. Is anyone looking at this character? Doesn't seem like anyone really looks at him, so if I throw a shuriken at him and take him out, I think that's it. He'd be done with.
I'm going in.
Should be able to get around quite a bit without having to worry about much because of the crouch line of sight that everyone has. Oh, shit.
Have to take a shortcut.
I thought there was two civilians. There's three.
No noise.
One more problem for the list. I think I can just
move like water.
Thread the needle here. Good.
Quiet.
Let's go up. Shit!
I warn you. I will call for help.
Maybe they won't notice me.
I'm going in.
Whee! I'm a ninja.
No noise.
That's amusing. Did she just run away? I think she got over it. Okay, that's not a big deal. I think I can just accept that brief detection.
I never miss.
So this guy's gonna spot it. Okay, that's what I need to plan my thing around then, is watch for the moment where he looks around. Maybe I can stash the body somewhere. I don't see a lot of options nearby though, admittedly. Let's try this.
Ready.
I'll wait for him to leave the ring, and then I'll knock him out real quick. Oh, somebody did spot him. Jesus, okay. I thought nobody was looking down here. Was it the noise? Was it the radius for crouching? Line of sight? Huh.
Shuriken, ready.
You son of a bitch. Okay, maybe if he looks around, turns around, I'll be able to take care of it.
Cutting wind.
That timing was all the difference. Okay, but I need to reach a body though.
Quite got it.
Quickly, quickly, quickly.
I'm going in.
Quickly, quickly, quickly. No noise. Oh my god. It worked.
Move like water.
Woo! Hoo 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 hoo! How's that? I like the idea that this guy's job is that he comes out of his house and moves boxes from the right side of his house to the left side of his house, and then he goes back in his house. What a weird pattern. Okay. So that took care of all the guards in this entire area. Downstairs. That's a good start, I think. There is a tutorial message over there that I'm interested in finding out about. But there's also people that don't want me to reach that spot. Of course, they get me used to the idea of my new disguise power and then take it away immediately, so I can't use it anymore. If I jump on this roof, could I... Nah, I don't think I could reach anything from the roof. There's a sniper spot we could use. Maybe to take out their samurai character from a distance? That has to be what we do, right? Who the hell takes out a samurai otherwise? It has to be a gunshot. Because we've already established that the ninja cannot take them. So we have to crouch our way all the way to the sniper tower, but the problem there is that there's tons of guards everywhere to worry about. So we'll just have to try to slowly clear our way. Tanuki would help here, for sure. So I believe my next objective should be to try to clear our way through here. I need to try to get my my ninja characters across. That was a little startling.
Good trick.
So if I stay crouched, I should have a clear line of sight. Cool.
Yes. Patience.
I think we're clear. Poor guy is so slow because of his missing leg. So we have to plan around that too. I see no ways to get up this cliff, really. There's no hooks, there's no vines. So I think we just have to go around. It might be possible for her to hop over here. It doesn't seem like the right shape, though. So going up the stairs, we need a distraction to keep the area clear. Is this the guy that goes back and forth? No, this is the guy that goes back and forth. So a distraction for him would be helpful. Just to make sure nobody comes by. So you've got the rock throw that can be distracting long enough to take this guy out. But there's a civilian next to him, which is a new problem. So maybe we use a tanuki to distract the civilian while we kill him and walk away with the body? Although he might just look at the well for long enough for that not to be an issue, possibly. But then this guy goes back and forth too. There's a lot to keep track of here. I could do a spike trap, but the problem with the spike trap is it's really obvious, and so when it goes off, everyone will probably notice that. That's probably a better option for this dude, but at that point, the line of sight's so clear. If I take out the first guy, then at that point, it's probably not a big deal to take out the second guy. I'm gonna try to do it with just Hayato. Let's see if that works. Waiting for this guy to go away, then I'll distract the other two. Ah, no! Don't do this to me right now! I'm trying to do a thing.
So, you simply lost these documents, which could lead anyone straight to Mansuru.
Oh, forgive me, Yabu-sama. We also discovered our guards were attacked, and Takuma has gone.
Then you are a fool. No doubt Shogunate men freed Takuma from his prison. The old cripple tried to kill me before. If the Shogun does not come for me, Takuma surely will. Do you realize now what your incompetence has cost me?
Please, Yabu-sama, I have failed you. I am deeply shamed. Will you grant this humble person permission to commit seppuku?
Very well. Perhaps you will at least die with some dignity. You, assist him.
Oh, thank you, Yabu-sama.
Quick! And be done with it. Damn the Shogun. Prepare paper and ink. I must write a letter to Kagesama. The rest of you, remove this one and clean the floor. You must be finished before I have tea with my wife.
Man, what impact did that just have on my timing?
Guess he's not Kage-sama after all.
Indeed. Still, this changes nothing. Lord Yabu must die.
You're out for him, aren't you? He said as much himself.
Oh, yes. I have a score to settle. But consider this. If we leave now, he will flee and continue to support Kage-sama.
He's a bad man. I know it. What do you think, Hayato-sensei?
Oh, fine. If you want your revenge, old man, then let's do this. I'll get paid either way.
Ah, I see we understand each other.
Tower is manned.
Ah, the perfect time to test my new long-range rifle.
This might be my best chance. We'll just test it out and see how it works out. 5T1.
Move like water.
Go for it. Who's seeing me right now? Oh, shit. Holy crap. Holy crap. On top of everything else, there's someone up top. Okay, so I probably have to take a shot with a rifle then, huh? There's a guy up in a tower? Oh, but I can just go straight up there. Interesting. I think they're trying to teach me something there, too. There's clearly a thing there. Wow, what a narrow line of sight where he can spot... No, never mind. He can spot you throughout the whole area. Alright, so 5... Shift... T...
A wise choice.
Have that ready. Huh. I think you're just supposed to shoot him. And that's it. Interesting.
What was that?
Ah, the stock needs reinforcing.
There's a pistol in your leg. Did you build it?
A hidden firearm. Your leg's the base, your cane's the barrel. Not a bad idea, old man.
Let's try the same strategy then.
I'm glad you like it.
Move like water.
Come on, distract them.
Quiet. Samurai at the gate.
No!
We lack.
Okay, that doesn't work probably. It was worth a shot.
I'm glad you like it.
So this guy sees everything? Yeah. If I threw a shuriken at the right time, I might be able to take him out. When he, like, have him fall down between looks? How's this guy see? He doesn't look over there at all. That guy might see him, though. There's so many people here. Okay.
Move like water.
Come on, distract them.
Nope. That's within the noise radius of the other character. Okay. There's so many ways to do this wrong. Okay. How do I proceed here? So he's too close to this
guy. You shoot again.
What if I just do it here?
Come on, distract them.
Ah, crap. Oh, it didn't matter. Maybe no one will notice. Quickly. Oh wow, that totally worked. Okay. Without Mugen, you need teamwork to take out a samurai. Use firearms to stun a samurai, then finish them off with a melee attack. Oh god. Okay, so it's a two-phase kill. Samurai will only be stunned briefly, so make sure you can finish them quickly. Takuma's grenades also kill samurai, but they are better saved up for larger groups.
Samurai, at the gate.
We lack Mugen's power. No matter. Samurai armor does not protect against good strategy.
Okay, so... we need to shoot the samurai with a bullet, and then immediately kill them, otherwise they'll get back up and start killing people. And we can use them with grenades to take them out instantly, which, like I suspected. But the problem with grenades is that they are good for groups, and groups are something to worry about in this game, because unlike before, I no longer can instantly take out a group of enemies with a single AoE attack. Nobody has that, because we lack samurai once again. So there she comes. I need to figure out how to handle that, or I can just ignore it, I suppose. So, and as per usual, the important character is totally covered in samurai, to make it so you can't just deal with them directly, because you would just be super dead from super samurai all over the place. Obvious concern is how much can these guys see the surrounding area? Probably a lot. So the people on top of the building can probably see your approach to this spot. And this spot itself has four guards? Not counting the guys out here. Jesus Christ, okay. There's always a lot of complications to be had. I love how they...
That's enough, Kuma.
I'm really amused by the fact that they just get bored with the animal.
You did well.
Okay, so... no one really looks over here. If I'm careful, I could just take that guy out. Quick shuriken strike. Oh, it's a big AoE. What if I just do this?
Don't need a blade for that.
KO.
Got it.
I figured there might not be anything stopping me from just doing that. Am I safe up here?
Move like water.
That's kind of neat. Okay, so now I'm up on the roof. So that's where I need the sniper to be if I want to use him as a sniper. Although maybe not yet. Oh, he'd have to come in from the bottom anyway because he has to climb the ladder inside this building by going over there. So that's for later. For now, I need to figure out how to deal with this guy.
Oh, help!
Attackers!
Who goes there?
Good thought.
So he's freaking out the guards, so I should go hide before somebody spots me. There should be no one for them to spot, really.
Shuriken, ready.
I can't help but try it.
Quiet. Move like water.
I can't get him? Line of sight problem?
I'm going.
Woo! I should not be here. That was a mistake. That was a mistake. Didn't really mean to hop down there. I wanted him to go on top of the roof past the railing so he could throw a projectile down, but I guess that's not an option. So this is just a temporary problem for us to deal with.
We're not hunting ghosts.
Don't suppose you guys could just go away.
Are they sure they saw something?
Certain you saw something?
I would love to just take them all out, but I'd have to shoot him once, and that makes it a lot harder. Yeah, let's let them spread out again.
Where is he?
I think it's probably generally a really bad idea to try to take out a cluster of enemies unless they're all unarmored characters that can be hit by the samurai, but they're both armored and I have no samurai. So we'll just let that pass by. So there's two guards here, one way over here. He's far enough away it shouldn't be a problem, but he could totally... he could see someone standing, which means he would spot somebody going down if they got killed. So if I wait around for him to leave, we can largely... okay, and he looks around. This guy alternates between looking here and the other direction, but this side he has terrible line of sight because of the rock that blocks his view. So it'd be really easy just to go hop in that bush over there, which I might want to put all of my characters in.
No straight path. Quiet.
My mind is playing tricks on me. Let's try to get everyone up to a spot where they're useful.
Shh, quiet. Soft souls. The fox is hunting.
The fox is hunting. Ruh-roh. Woohoo! Got away with it. No regrets, no regrets.
No one will notice.
How much... Almost ran directly in front of that guy. That was close.
Ah, patience.
No yes. One look over here. I'll just wait a moment. There we go. Alright, we've all made it this far. Probably not a good idea generally put everyone in the same spot. How do I get rid of this? I'm trying to get rid of the Tanuki thing. What happens when I hit enter? Nothing, right? Yeah. It's like a nonsensical action to take. Okay. We probably want to use the Tanuki.
Kuma.
To make that guy look the other way for a bit. Probably while the samurai is looking the other direction. If I'm really careful, I could set up a trap like right here.
A curious design.
Let's get you away from them in the bush.
Mm-hmm. It sleeps most of the time, but it gets really excited when you wind it up.
Is that so?
So maybe I can get him to walk.
It works. Perhaps you'll show me later.
Yeah, I want him to walk directly into that.
If you want. Hey, where's the little trap? Lovely tree.
I think I timed this incorrectly.
Don't try to hide.
Shit. 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 That's a bad plan. I forgot to check the noise radius. I was trying to rapidly get the action out, and I realized that I didn't have the hotkeys down, so I was like, ah, crap, where did I leave that one? Okay. There's no reason to lure him into the trap. Let's see.
Kuma! Kuma, go. You know what to do.
So create a distraction. Murder. Crap. Ah, the number of variables to keep track of. Okay. So I need to make sure that that guy is not looking... He has to be on the other part of his patrol. Okay. So five...
Fireworks are ready. Kuma, listen. Kuma, go.
Okay. I need that guy to look away too. So he's probably going to look back here again, so I'll wait for the samurai to look back here too, and then turn around again while this guy... Yeah, that guy's leaving now. Okay. Shit. All these moving parts screwing with me right now. Oh, he's already back. Okay. That's a pain. Where's the limit of your line of sight? Pretty far. Okay then.
Kuma.
Let's plan this then. Let's see if I can lure him out of the line of sight over here. Of everybody.
Ready?
Like maybe somewhere where no one would notice him
your
dying? Yep, that went to shit. That guy looks over here?
Protect us.
That guy looks over there? I thought he looked somewhere else. He must have finished his patrol. Crap. Okay.
Kuma.
So send you over there. Yeah, he probably finished his patrol and was looking in that direction. Yeah.
Get your arms, Kuma.
Shurikenjutsu. Cutting wind.
Now there's no one to spot him. And since he's down, no one should see him. So now I use the smaller character to sneak up and take the body away. Oh, that was close. Not a problem, though. There we go. Let's have you return.
Kuma, return.
Right, you have to go get the shuriken yourself. She really should have grabbed it for him. Too bad. Okay. That's one down. Okay, so that's how we can use the Kuma to create a remote distraction that lures them away from the line of sight of the more problematic characters. The limit of his line of sight is one thing to worry about.
You know what to do.
This guy can't see crap far away, right? Okay. Yeah, that's the... If I kill him over there, he'll be in a location where, no one will see him go down. Or once he's down, no one will see him. Fall down. Fall down. There we go. Okay, yeah. He finished falling down fast enough. So now, once again, I can just crawl on over and take the body back without anyone spotting it.
Kuma,
There we go.
There you are.
Nice. You go get the shuriken again. No one should be able to spot you because you're crouching. There we go. Why is... Can I not get it to go away?
Kuma, go. No one will notice.
Okay, there we go. It went away now.
Kuma, a wise
oopsie.
Choice. Kuma.
Okay, there we go. I was trying to figure out how to get rid of the giant floating icon over him. I think I recalled Kuma while he was still poised to do his to go make noise. And so Kuma was just permanently in that state where I think the icon never went away. Even though when I put Kuma out, it still wouldn't, it wouldn't show up over here like in a command, so I don't even know if enter would have worked. But it was staying there. So, that guard's still there. I can probably get away with not killing him, though. Let's work on getting you somewhere. Yes. I probably don't need to be in the tower. I can probably just shoot him from here, right?
My hands are steady.
Is that clear line of sight or not? No, the stairs are the wrong angle. Oh, no, that seems like it'd work.
Just a moment.
And it moves with him, so it'll stay. It'll keep line of sight active. Good. So then we just need to be ready to actually do the stab when it happens. And I think nobody will see him right now. Okay. Let's have Hayato do it. So the moment he turns around, I'm taking the shot and stabbing him. But I'm concerned people might come bursting through the door at that moment, so we'll see.
Quiet. I'm going in.
Crouch. There we go.
Quiet. Time for sword work.
Shit.
Move like
it's a really bad time, dude. Okay, well, I'm just gonna go hide over here. Okay, that's bad. I probably didn't want that kind of noise to happen. Maybe I can still work around it, though. Aha! No alarm raised. Okay.
I'm going in.
Okay, let's... Is he coming over here? I'm gonna knock him out.
Taijutsu.
Gods! You
quiet.
God damn it.
Show yourself.
So many of you guys. I don't think it matters. They can't. There's no guards left, so I don't think they can actually raise the alarm. These guys apparently won't check outside the door because they were suspicious, but they're like, eh.
No noise.
So they just kind of wrote it off. So that's one guy down. I've used multiple long range shots, though. Should I have used the flintlock pistol for that? I probably could use the flintlock for that, huh? Didn't really think it through. Because the flintlock, despite what you'd expect, the flintlock doesn't actually have that big of a noise radius. So I could have shot him with that, probably. Maybe from down here? I don't know, the bushes are pretty spread out. Could always check real quick. That would be better for my answers. Let's find out. Nah, that angle doesn't seem right. So my option was long range from back here or up there, basically. Maybe down here? The angles don't seem right, though. No, I think I had to use the long range rifle. Alright, so we're down to 3 shots. And my only way through is this gate.